Namaskar students, in this video we shall be learning about relational database. Now what do you mean by the term relational database? Whenever we store the data or organize the data in the form of tables is what is known as relational database. You can see a table over here which consists of three columns and four rows. Rows are called field and columns are called attributes. Now every value or record that you store inside this table have got relationship among themselves, because of which the name relation is given to a table. So we know now that the alternate name for tables is also relation, because every values stored in the table have got relationship among themselves. Now what is keys? We can see a table over here by the name of suppliers. There are four attributes: supply number, supply name, status and city. Now if you see the values under the attributes carefully, you will find that under the attribute status, two values, 10 and 10, is repeated, and under the attribute city, two values, Delhi and Delhi, is repeated twice. Now under the attribute supply name, all the values are unique. Also under the attribute supply number, all the values are unique. Now coming to the keys. What are keys? Keys are basically one or more attributes that uniquely identifies any record of a table. Now clearly, as per the rules or as per the requirement, only two columns are fulfilling, that is supply number and supply name, which does not have any repeat value and are uniquely identifying the record of a table. Because of that, the two attributes supply number and supply name can act as the candidate key for the table suppliers. Now when there are two attributes for the candidate keys, the database analyst can decide which one can act as the primary key. So over here, the primary key can be supply number, because among supply number and supply name, the supply number is more unique, because supply name sometimes can also be repeated, though supply name is not repeated over here in this example. So supply number can be the primary key, which is uniquely identifying the record of a table, and the other attribute which can be the candidate key but not the primary key will act as the alternate key. So both alternate key and primary key are the candidate keys, but one particular attribute which is more uniquely identifying the record of a table acts as the primary key, and the other candidate key which is not the primary key act as the alternate key for the table. Now let us define the keys that we have learnt as per the previous example. Candidate key is a set of attributes that uniquely identify tuples in a table, tuples or record as I said earlier. Under candidate key, primary key and alternate key is coming. Primary key is a set of one or more attributes that can uniquely identify tuples within the relation. And what is alternate key? Alternate key is a candidate key that is not the primary key. Composite primary key. Consider the example of the table shipments. There are three attributes: supply number, item number, quantity supplied. Now if you see the values of the attribute supplier number, S1, 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 S2, S2, S3, S4. Three times the value S1 is repeated, two times the value S2 is repeated. Come to item number attribute, I2, I3, I6, I4, I5, I2, I3. I3 is repeated twice, I2 is repeated twice. Now come under quantity supplied. Over here also, 10 is repeated twice, 20 is repeated twice, 30 is repeated twice. Now in such a situation, how can we select the primary key for the table? Because none of the attributes is uniquely identifying any of the record of the table. So in such cases, we have to see whether any combination of two attributes can act as a primary key. If we see the combination of supply number and item number, let us see S1, I2, S1, I3, S1, I6, S2, I4, S2, I5, S3, I2, S4, I3. Over here, if we combine supply number and item number and consider, we will see that the combination is unique. In this kind of a situation, where combination of two attributes is forming a unique primary key, it is called composite primary key. So what is composite primary key? Composite primary key is when the primary key consists of more than one attribute. So over here in this example, composite primary key is supplier number and item number as indicated through the green box.